Thank you, sir. Before beginning this short duration discussion on cancer, let me make an appeal to the chairman. 15 parties comprising about half the strength of this house have submitted a notice for a short duration
discussion. Please, on this subject.
Just one line.
No, no. That will not go on record.
It is,
you are losing your time.
Important.
You are losing, Professor, your
very
time.
Very important for the nation.
Your leader has said it, they will take care of. Don't worry.
Anyway, shall I continue?
No, continue on cancer prevention.
Anyway, now to cancer. All of us know someone who has been impacted by cancer. I am an artist, sir, and I will not give you statistics to measure the immensity of the problem. The courage and fights put up by our near and dear ones is imprinted in our minds and our hearts. Yesterday we passed a bill here to supposedly empower women. More women in India die from cervical cancer than in any other country. Have you, the government, done
anything to
protect our
women?
You have
to look at the chair and then speak. Professor, you can just refer, but
okay,
should not read.
Okay.
Don't think otherwise,
all
that's
right.
The rule.
Okay, thank you. Sir, HPV vaccine can prevent this. Why is the vaccine not a part of the national immunization program? Breast cancer counts for the highest death amongst women due to cancer, due to failure in diagnosing breast cancer in early stages. But government have not done anything to protect our women in this case. We will not accept this because both cervical and breast cancers are preventable, easily detectable, and effectively treatable if detected early. But that too, also government has not done anything for the women. Oral cancer is the most common cancer amongst men and can be effectively by tobacco control. Yet this budget saw a decline in allocation to the tobacco control program and drug de-addiction program. Let me share with you the initiatives successfully implemented by the government of Bengal. This supports the cancer patients during their treatment as well as after the treatment. Since 2015, treatment of all types of cancer and blood disorders is completely free in Bengal state-run hospitals. This includes free medicine, radiotherapy and chemotherapy, and free beds in all government hospitals. 5 state-of-the-art linear accelerator LINAC machines for external beam radiation treatment for cancer patients is under installation and is being tested in 3 medical colleges. Additionally, 3 numbers of tertiary cancer centers at a total cost of rupees 93 crores are being set up at Burdwan Medical College and Hospital, Murshidabad Medical College and Hospital, and College of Medicines and Sagar Dutt Hospital. A regional cancer center with a project cost of rupees 47 crores is coming up at Medical College and Hospital, Kolkata. Bengal government is setting up state-of-the-art cancer centers in 3 cities, Murshidabad, Vardhaman, and Kolkata. Every state should have these dedicated units focusing on research and treatment of cancer. To enable a more accessible healthcare framework, Bengal government's group health protection scheme, Shastra Sathi, started in 2017 as basic health coverage for secondary and tertiary care of care up to rupees 1.5 lakhs per annum per family through insurance mode, and up to 5 lakhs for critical diseases including cancer. Further follow-up cancer chemotherapy is provided on day care basis at the district hospitals in Kuchbihar, Jalpaiguri, Howrah, Nodia, Murshidabad, Purulia, Poshchim Medinipur and Purva Bardhaman. Setting up of similar facilities at other district hospitals is underway. Honorable Chairman, there are gaping holes in our current policies, and it is not surprising that these policies are failing. We have enough numbers reflecting the urgency of this issue. Do you need more proof to convince the government? I hope Government of India will take steps in line with the Government of Bengal, which has successfully and effectively intervened in the cancer crisis we are collectively now facing. Thank you, sir.